Halo 5 Warzone Firefight being consolidated. Halo 5's ranking system changing quite a bit when it comes to this new season of Spring 2020. And general playlist updates to keep you guys up to date with everything going on in Halo. So stay tuned throughout the whole thing to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another news informational video when it comes to Halo. If you like these news informational videos, please make sure to tap that like button, as it greatly helps out the video and channel, keeps the community up to date with everything going on in Halo. So let's get right into the content here. Well, this is going to be my first like Halo 5 focused video in quite some time, as it's been pretty stagnant on that side when it comes to updates and changes and things going on with the game. And everything that does change, it's so minor, it's not even worth mentioning. This time around, we're getting some big changes when it comes to Halo 5's playlist and the ranking system as well. So let's get right into it. So we're going to start off with probably what you're concerned about is Warzone Firefight. Is that being consolidated into two playlists instead of three playlists? Essentially, what they've been noticing is that Heroic, Warzone, Firefight has a pretty steady population that's always going to be there no matter what. But they've noticed that a lot of players who play Legendary Warzone, Firefight hop over and play Mythic Warzone, Firefight during the weekends. And so during that time, Legendary Firefight is basically non-existent in play, like people playing it, because everyone who's playing Legendary plays Mythic. And so what they're doing is they're going to be combining, in quotes, as they mentioned here, we'll get into more specifics of why it's in quotes, of combining Legendary and Heroic Firefight into just Warzone Firefight. And you're probably wondering, wait, is it going to be two different difficulties? No. Basically, what's happening is it's going to basically play like Heroic Warzone Firefight. Same playlist, same level of difficulty and everything like that, but you'll be gaining the XP from what it would be if it was Legendary Warzone Firefight. That's where the combine came from. Basically, the gameplay is Heroic Warzone Firefight. The XP gains are Legendary Warzone Firefight. Now you're probably wondering about what's going on with Mythic. Mythic is actually going to stay permanently in the game now as a high tier Warzone Firefight edition. So there's always going to be Heroic Firefight and Mythic Warzone Firefight are going to be in the game. This is probably what I think they should have done a long time ago, because I feel like it was a bit redundant having Heroic, Legendary, and Mythic. Mythic is really hard. It is definitely a challenge where you need to actually coordinate and use your recs properly. So it's like actually a really fun challenge when you're playing with friends. Legendary, you can kind of solo it if you know what you're doing. And Heroic is just fun to hop in and blow stuff up. So I think this is a really good change that 343 is making with the Warzone Firefight playlist. But let me know in the comment section down below, guys, what your thoughts are on that, because I do read a lot of comments and try to reply to most of them as well. So we go into a little extra updating goodness when it comes to Halo 5. We have a ranking system update that came with the Spring 2020 changes, and they're quite significant as well. If any of you guys are out there still playing Team Arena, still playing your ranked matches, and you have some rather big frustrations, which I've definitely experienced with the way the ranking system works, a lot of things have been changed. One thing is that I'm sure if you guys have been trying to rank up and play, you might have noticed that when someone on the other team quits, you get like no CSR, or like one, maybe, if that. It's really frustrating, because a lot of times when you're playing well and doing well against another team, the other team will quit out because they're just gonna lose, so they'll just quit. So it screws you out of gaining your CSR and ranking up, and they just get to leave the game, no problem right there, and lose the CSR that they were gonna lose no matter what. And so the change is gonna be is that the team that actually is staying in and playing is actually going to gain the CSR that they should have gained without dealing with the lack of CSR from someone else on the other team quitting. Though, this does cause an effect. I did notice that players on teams, that what they would do to prevent CSR loss is that they would make someone on their team purposely quit, and so then the team that is having the person who quits doesn't lose any CSR, or loses less CSR, as I should say. And so what they're going to do now is, if you have someone who's in your party and they leave, you know, they try to diminish your CSR loss, you're still going to lose that CSR that you would have lost anyways, just so then you can't manipulate the system and maintain your high rank. Excellent move right here by Menke and the team right there to make sure that that is happening. I wish that kind of happened sooner, but you know what? It's Halo 5. I think they're running pretty slow when it comes to changes on that, but I'm really happy to see that change. Another change here for all you Onyx tier players, which I certainly am not, but I've been close, but I never really got there too in Halo 5, is that they're looking to actually diminish the amount of gains and losses when it comes to your CSR. As the population has diminished quite a bit in Halo 5, you get some questionable teammates when it comes to playing ranked Halo 5 when it comes to if you're an Onyx tier player. I mean, I played a game the other night where the guy who was Onyx matched with a guy who was getting his placement matches a gold and a silver. There's, in a logical sense, there should be no reason why an Onyx should match with silver players, but like I said, the population is so low right now that stuff is just going to happen. I'd rather play the game and get like a somewhat fair match with unbalanced kind of matchmaking algorithm right there, rather than just not play the game at all, like we're experiencing with Halo Reach Hardcore. And so that's what they're looking to do, so then the swings won't be so grand. It also make that grind up to champion a little bit easier, because they notice that Onyx players tend to actually just kind of beat up a lot on maybe lower tier players, since they've been matching against those, that it will make you a higher rank Onyx than you really should be. So they're trying to match up that MMR and that CSR, kind of leveling up together, and it looks like they're going to try to do that just fine. And it looks like they're also going to raise the minimum CSR for champion from 1500 to 1600 CSR, because before, basically, if you're like first in a playlist or just grinded the Halo 5 a lot, that a lot of times you can go from straight from Diamond 6 to Champion because no one else has gotten up to Onyx yet. So these give up players a little bit more of a grind to get up to Champion. I think that's a proper move right there for sure. Now, that came with the spring season that came around a few days ago, but now there's another update that came for Halo 5 saying that there's been an issue also with players gaining no CSR. Basically, when you win and you probably won a match and performed exactly how you should have, then you don't really gain that much CSR. Obviously, seeing that happen can be a little disheartening. So at least now they changed it, so you'd be gaining at least 1 out of 30 possible points for CSR on that one right there. They do mention about some changes as well when it comes to Onyx CSR as well, and looking like it's been acting properly, and I'm just kind of keep along with that process. And since we're talking about playlist updates for Halo 5 and stuff like that, this is the rest of the month of March and April we can see right here coming in. We have Hardcore Super Fiesta returning on April 1st out of all days to bring back that weird freaking playlist. That is 100% the day to do it on April 1st. That is just hilarious right there. Now, actually, and also right now, guys, that they're going to bring back Rock and Rail on April 23rd, which is going to be a place you're going to want to grind if you're still trying to get that 152. That is absolutely the one you would need to do. ODST Slayer coming in on April 16th, which that is a super fun place. I really like ODST Slayer, and I definitely guys want to give that go. Talking about the XP grinds, right now in Halo, MCC, and Halo 5, you can actually earn global double XP. As we all know, we're all kind of staying inside right now during the current virus. I can't say the C word because I'll get demonetized on YouTube. Found that one out in my E3 video. And so, yeah, make sure that you can jump into Halo 5, get that 152, play any playlist, you get double XP. Same thing with MCC, get grinding your 1 through 100 tiers and get your double XP that way. And since we're talking about MCC, I also got a playlist update as well. The rotational playlist change, Fiesta rotates in for all games in the MCC as Griffball rotates out. Halo CE Fiesta, all new Fiesta game types available on Battle Creek, Damnation, Prisoner, Chill Out, Derelict, Wizard, and Longest. Fiesta will be available as a featured category. And like we mentioned earlier, double XP gains all over the place. It's quite amazing. Pro tip for all you PC players, you want to play CE if you're trying to get the XP gains, because CE just dumps you with XP. Reach is actually not that good. If you're for your console players, I've heard Halo 2 is really good. H2A, I know for sure, is really good when it comes to grinding out XP, so definitely want to hop on that, guys, when you get a chance. So that's all the news going on right now with Halo 5 and the MCC as of today. We might hear a little bit more of the MCC Halo 2 flighting update as Friday rolls around here. We'll get an update from Postums. I'll make sure to give you guys a video about that as soon as that goes live. So make sure you tap subscribe on the channel, guys, to keep yourself up to date with everything going on in Halo. If you miss any content from me, make sure you check out the videos on the screen right now. I got some videos to a playlist that's all my news videos that you might have missed. Check out that playlist right there, guys, to keep yourself up to date. So let's check you guys all in the next video. Peace out.